side by the Huskers, but Ben Franklin's alma mater is higher than a kite there, leading by 9:30, 9:30. We'll keep you posted. We'll be here throughout the night, and updates coming in, of course, at halftime as well. But right now we're getting set for Missouri and Navy out in Ogden. Tim Ryan and Ann Myers will have the call, and already a surprise out there in the West today. So take it away, Tim and Ann.
Jim, the D Event Center on the campus of Weber State University in Ogden, Utah, has been the site of one upset already here today. As we head into the evening action, the third game of the first round, and Navy hoping to perhaps follow the success of the upset victory of Wisconsin-Green Bay as they have advanced to play Syracuse, winners over Hawaii, in the opener today. Later, it'll be Cincinnati-Wisconsin. Hi, everybody. Jim Ryan with Hall of Famer Ann Myers here. And this Navy team started out 5-10 this year. They're playing the top-seeded Missouri team. Missouri, a couple of question marks of their own, hoping for more success than they've had in the past. A couple of distractions. Two of their players suspended for at least a game by Coach Norm Stewart. We'll talk a little bit more about that as we go along. But what about the these distractions as they may affect the number one seed?
Well, he feels that they've really got to concentrate on this game, and this is going to be a key game for his players to really get into it and see how they're going to do, because they have struggled in past tournaments.
Well, defense is what both of these teams pride themselves on, and two of the small men could be the real figures in this game.
Well, for Missouri, 6'2 senior, he is the go-to guy, Melvin Booker, and he is a big player for them because, obviously, in the Big Eight, he was player of the year. So he's going to create a lot of things. He's averaging over 17 points and 4 assists a game for this Missouri team.
At 6'2", he is the shortest, the smallest of the starters on the Missouri team. But how about this guy? At 5'8", Ryan Walker has really turned the Navy fortunes around.
And only a freshman. They have won 12 games that he has started out of the 15. And that has been a big difference. They have a junior varsity at Navy, and he started out that way. And they've got a lot of freshmen on this team, but he is a big difference, even at his size.
Well, he is joined in the backcourt by T.J. Hall, who is their leading scorer at 13.7 a game. Michael Green and Wes Cooper are the forwards. Alex Conan is the center. For Missouri, it'll be at front. Julian Winfield and Kelly Thames, a real outstanding freshman. The guards are Melvin Booker and Lamont Frazier, and the center is Javon Crudup at 6'9", a senior from Kansas City. Norm Stewart, in his 27th season, 637 victories, an outstanding college coaching career. And Don DeVoe, who says this team has been the most satisfying that he has ever had this season with Navy, just his second year with the midshipmen, watching them come back from a 5-10 start to finish the season at 17-12 into the NCAAs for the ninth time, and they haven't been here since 1986-87. They lost that year in the first round of Michigan.
Well, they definitely work hard in practice. Yesterday we saw that they were running lines. That's something to do in preseason.
Missouri in white. And we have an early beat.
The 35-second clock not working.
Well, that stopped action barely 15 seconds into this game. Missouri's Tigers 25-3, 14-0 unbeaten in the Big Eight this year. And then in the Big Eight tournament, they lost to Nebraska in the championship game. And it's just been another one of these little setbacks that make Missouri fans nervous. Did it help or hurt them to have that loss? Hard to say.
I think you've got to look at the positive way, Tim, as far as losing to Nebraska like that. Then you've got to refocus. And Norm Stewart has taken his team, and you talked about the other distractions they've had coming here. But losing a game right before tournament time would seem to refocus his team and say, hey, you lose one more, we're really out of it.
Now Norm Stewart and the timers and the officials getting things sorted out. And the Navy band is off and roaring here. Larry Limbo is the referee, sorting it out with the timers. To the distractions of the Missouri Tigers team, Paul Olinney, one of their top reserves, a junior guard from Pensacola, Florida, involved in a little altercation back in Columbia, Missouri, just a few nights ago. There was an arrest. Olinney is with the team, but he has been suspended for at least this game by Norm Stewart. Stewart also suspended. There is Olinney down at the end of the bench. And he has also suspended Derek Johnson, the sophomore from Jefferson City, Missouri, who was late for the team plane coming to the tournament. Johnson is not here at all. And Norm Stewart says he's also out, at least for this game. And one would suspect, should they win, he will not turn up here on the weekend either. But Johnson does not figure as heavily into their game plan as Foligny, who is one of their key reserve players. And they still haven't resolved this buzzer and clock thing. You can see they've counted it down to 30, and it's going down lower now, the shot clock. Well, there's back to 35. They're having problems, obviously.
They're going to have to reset the regular clock also. Maybe they ought to just reset everything and start the game over.
Well,
it's
yeah.
Not that big deal.
I would agree with you.
Score.
No score. There it is. We played, as you can see. Well, we had played 15 seconds. That's being revised also.
Yeah, why don't they just jump ball it again?
Well, the midshipman. Ready. These guys have been pounding those drums for some time.
They're waiting for the first basket.
So here we go. Ryan Walker, the 5'8 guard from Marion, Indiana. Happened this time.
The shot clock went off after about 5 seconds.
Aha. Uh-huh. Well, we've got a major electronic problem here to start this game between the top seed here in Ogden and in the entire West, for that matter, the West region of this NCAA tournament, Missouri.
It's interesting that in today's day and age, with the breakable rims and the backboards, and we've seen boards shattered and 35-second clocks being malfunctioned, and even the regular clocks, that they aren't prepared, and I'm not just saying here, but throughout the country, that they're not more prepared to have backups ready to go if there is a malfunction.
Well, we can see somebody over there working on the electronics at the bench in the timers area at the courtside bench.
Talk about pressure.
There's one little wire and another. That, but we have yet to play a minute here in Ogden, Navy in Missouri. Later this evening, the University of Wisconsin will take on Cincinnati's Bearcats. Well, there's a good look at Walker in comparison to his teammates. Nobody recruited him in Marion, Indiana. That's a hotbed of basketball, not far from Indianapolis. And at 5'8", there were no takers, perhaps a few colleges.
Hey.
Well, sorry about that, Ann, but in Brian Walker's case, only the service academies went after him. He was interested in the Naval Academy. They got him. And I don't think that even Don DeVoe and his coaching staff would say that they had any idea he would turn out to be so significant. A freshman who did not start the season as a starter, but proved that he could be a valuable asset. And since he came in, as you said at the opening of our telecast, they have won 12 and lost 3.
Well, he has a brother also in the Navy, so that kind of sways you a little bit.
Sure. We watched him in practice yesterday, and he can jump. Do not be deceived. He can get up there, and he's very, very quick. Left-handed shooter, averaging 6 points a game. Inside Conan, the ball knocked back into the Navy zone, and that's going to be a turnover with the ball going to Missouri.
See how much pressure Missouri puts defensively on Navy as far as controlling the basketball.
So Booker, the point guard, quickly to Frazier, inside to Kruda. Thames, the freshman, brilliant player, Mr. Basketball in the state of Missouri, and a 3.9 great point average in high school.
Very, very patient on the offensive end.
And Krutoff is fouled by Alex Conan, the sophomore from St. Louis, 6'11 center of the Naval Academy. Check it, they've called it on Michael Green. Michael Green, the forward number 42, gets the call.
Well, Navy does have a lot of guys on the bench dressed.
And the opening point goes to the Tigers of Missouri.
Devon Krutup, Big Eight, second team this year as a senior.
Misses the second. It's rebounded by Michael Green. Green, one of two freshman starters, along with Walker, for the Naval Academy.
Missouri doing a good job on their man-to-man defense. Navy not able to get the ball inside off of penetration or the pass.
Walker watched by Winfield. And the turnover, tried to slip it inside, Booker the other way. And he's fouled, the basket will count. And it looks like Michael Stewart, who may have his second, and Booker is ready to play. Elvin Booker, a senior. Lost Point, Mississippi.
Navy trying to get the ball inside, and they're just not executing on their offense right now. Missouri really anticipating and switching in their defense, able to step into the passing lane.
Bounce pass, didn't get there.
Navy just struggling right now offensively. They're trying to get things to work, but again, give credit to the man-to-man defense of Missouri, frustrating them. They have to be a little bit more patient on offense as far as setting those picks, waiting for them.
Navy at 17-12, tied for first in the Patriot Conference, and defeated Colgate in the conference championship. Their ninth appearance in the NCAAs. Last time back in 1987. Frazier trying to drive on Hall outside of Crudup.
Motion offense for Missouri, looking to get the ball inside. They called him out of bounds, but Devon Crudup really makes a nice baseline move underneath the basket.
Crudup stepped out.
Posting up. Cronin really working hard inside, but Crudup really has the advantage. They call him on the baseline, but he makes a nice move underneath.
Now again, it looks like we have a continuing problem with the timer. And the scoreboard, which did not go from 3-4. Well, earlier today at the Nassau Coliseum, George Washington and Connecticut advanced. Low-scoring game between Connecticut and Rider, but the number two seed in that region advancing through. Hall in the lane, yes. And Navy's first points, 4-2, Missouri. T.J. Hall, a junior from Port Jefferson, New York, the leading scorer at 13.7. Third game for the Middies.
Navy personal foul.
Michael Green,
Michael Green
picked up his third foul.
Personal foul.
And we have played
the 13th foul.
Still under 3 minutes.
Well, one of the reasons Michael Green has started for Navy, this has been his fourth game in a row, is because Victor Mikkel went out with a, how do you call it, a cadet code of ethics as far as the test was concerned, and he was one of their starters, and so in order not to change the lineup per se, Michael Green has been inserted into it.
Two Missouri lead. Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here at the D Event Center, Weber State University, Ogden, Utah. Syracuse and Wisconsin Green Bay in an upset of California advanced in the afternoon action. Later it'll be Cincinnati and University of Wisconsin.
13, Julian Winfield.
Winfield picks up his first personal. T.J. Hall. Two Tigers collided, and Hall fired it up over them. 4 points for him, tying it at four. Crudup. Missing. Rebounded by Wes Cooper, the junior from Woodbridge, Virginia.
Navy, with a disadvantage as far as size is concerned, really has to work on blocking out Missouri because they're such an aggressive team, Missouri, as far as going to the boards.
Conan off the back iron, and a good tip in by Hall.
T.J. Hall just gets his fingertips on it, gets the ball back up in there.
He's got all the points for Navy. 6-4.
Nice pass. Again on the line. Midshipman doing a good job defensively that time.
Timeout on the floor.
Lamont Frazier for Missouri with a timeout on the floor. 15:29 to go.
Crack open a smoother, better draft. Ice Draft from Budweiser. It's ice brewed, chilled below freezing, then cold filtered. From now on, a cold draft just isn't cool enough. Ask for Ice Draft, only from Budweiser. Before you buy a new car, consider the comfort. Consider the quiet. Consider the power. Consider the fit and the finish. But most importantly, before you buy a new car, consider these options. The Chevy S-Series, so new from the inside out, everything else is history.
New from Pizza Hut, the ultimate pepperoni pizza. Zesty herbs, thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste. But remember, one bite of this pizza and there's no going back. Try one for $8.99, a second medium for $5 more.
This time around, you can fly without wings. You can reach the heights. Soar in the endless night. This time around, you can fall without fear. Because everything's possible. This time around.
Airbag, seat belts, and anti-lock brakes. Child safety seats, careful driving, and a set of Michelins.
Tonight, laugh along with Sally Field, Carly Simon, and Robert Duvall.
Spouses who overspend on the next Dave.
Don DeVoe in his second year as head coach of the Naval Academy, and this year he is called his most satisfying ever in coaching, with this team coming back as well as they have. They won 7 in a row, 12 of the last 14, after starting out 5-10. Winning the Patriot Conference, and Hall has all the Navy points.
T.J. Hall, 8 points, and coming into this game last couple days, he's had strep throat, Jim Gray informed us, and so he didn't practice real hard yesterday.
Kelly Thames, the freshman from Jennings, Missouri, hits for the Tigers. Bad miss inside by Green. Navy keeps possession. Walker now sets it up again outside. Cooper's hook won't drop. Booker breaking. Mark Atkins.
Missouri possession.
Well, he was wide open. Took the shot. And Cooper got a hand on it.
Atkins, number 3, a senior from Gary, Indiana, entered during the last timeout for the Tigers.
Missouri on offense has been pretty patient within their half-court game. They're trying to get the ball inside. That time they turn it over, but they've really been pretty deliberate on their half-court game.
9-6 Navy lead. Walker Walker lost control of it.
Brian Walker has been complaining so far in this game that he's being bumped every time by Melvin Booker. Sometimes at that size, you don't get the calls all the time.
Four turnovers now by the Naval Academy.
The advantage you have it at 5'8", I think, is the fact that the ball is so low to the ground and your center of gravity is so low to the ground that you can attack at that defensive player.
Boot up being muscled by Conan. Back outside to Frazier. And it's missed from deep in the corner by Atkins.
This Navy team, you've got somebody like TJ Holland. He scores most of the points. Other players have to step up.
Foul will be called on Lamont Frazier, senior guard from Charleston, his first. Charleston, Missouri. Atkins goes out. And Norm Stewart sends in Jason Sutherland, number five, freshman guard from Watertown, South Dakota. Hall again, off the front iron. Rebounded by Booker, down below for Sutherland, and he waits for Walker to clear.
Jason Sutherland.
And it's 9-8. Remaining here in the first half. Conan's ball is batted away, but it's goaltending.
It's the first time Alex Conan has been able to touch the ball in the offensive set. He averages over 8 points a game, but they need to get him involved a little bit more. Nice pass in low, and there you see screwed up going up, knocking it away.
Ball on its way into the cylinder. Above the cylinder and into the basket. 11-8. Navy, 3-point lead.
Navy really dropping back on their defense, too. That middle should be clogged up a little bit more, but a nice pass inside.
Bruda missing inside. And Walker comes away. Walker to Conan. Little half hook off the front rim, and it'll be Missouri ball.
Missouri substitution, number 33, Kelly Thayer.
You know, we saw Navy practice really, really hard yesterday, Tim. They did a lot of running, and this altitude can really affect you, especially somebody like T.J. Hall. I've seen him miss a few shots. They're short. Maybe the legs aren't all there as of right now.
Beams back in for Missouri, and he hits and is fouled on the way. Kelly Thames.
Of course, they did tell us that when Navy goes on the road, the midshipmen love it because Don DeVoe does not practice as hard.
Well, off what we saw yesterday, it must be brutal at home. They had them running gassers after an hour's practice out here.
Shooting one.
Hall picked up the foul, and Thames on the line. Said Missouri's Mr. Basketball in high school, rookie of the year this year. An outstanding future ahead of this young man. Averaged 12 points a game for Missouri this year. And he comes up with a loose ball.
And that set right there, Missouri forced Navy to have T.J. Hall bring the ball up the court, trying to keep the ball out of Brian Walker's hands.
Sutherland outside with Booker. Booker's jumper. Battle for the rebound between Cooper and Thames.
Timeout on the floor.
And we have another timeout with 11:37 to go in the first half. We're tied at 11.
We're ball players and we're okay. We're not fat lazy like the bonus say. In spring we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball cards. They're ball players, or so they say. They'd rather be doing ads for Bengay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ink the deal to Hawk underwear.
We're ball players and we're okay. Get in shape.
shape by opening day. Thanks to these, we'll be ready to play. Oh, ship your butts to double A, yeah.
Introducing the first and only business calling plan that changes as fast as your business. Introducing the Most for Business from Sprint. The plan that instantly adapts to your changing calling patterns, so you're guaranteed automatic savings every month. So call now to get the most for business. Because when it comes to business, you'd better be able to change. After all, it's a jungle out there.
What would you expect from the country that invented rock and roll?
At the New York Sun, they cover the city.
You got 5 hours, go get the story.
Please don't be late.
You got 3 minutes.
I need four. Three.
But today, the biggest story.
What if there is? What if these aren't the guys?
Just might be their own.
I got something for you.
I love you.
Pop, they didn't do it as big as you can.
Run what we've got.
People will read this, Alicia, and they'll believe us.
Michael Keaton, Glenn Close, Marissa Tomei, and Robert Duvall. The Paper. Rated R. Starts tomorrow in select areas. Special sneak preview Saturday night everywhere.
What are you going to watch when basketball's over? I've got an idea. When the tournament's over, we'll be back.
Eye to Eye with Connie Chung returns March 31st.
Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here at the D Event Center in Ogden, Utah. The shade now of the Wasatch Mountains of the Rocky Mountain Range.
A very slow-paced game at this point. Almost 10 minutes gone in the first half. Missouri just seems a little tentative in their offense. They've been pretty patient, but they've had some turnovers, too. Navy sagging back on defense, and Navy has hung tough on them offensively, especially T.J. Hall.
Travel call on Derek Grimm for the first time. Battle for the loose ball, and Walker comes up with it, and Walker's jumper off the back rim. Grimm rebounds. Walker back the other way. Walker ties him up, and Walker picks up the foul.
Offensively, you can really see for Navy that T.J. Hall is not a great ball handler. They want to get the ball in the hands of Brian Walker. And defensively, that time, he comes up with his first personal.
Baines. Sutherland rebounds. Well, good effort by several players led by Grimm.
Some bodies flying right there. Again, the advantage that Brian Walker has being so small, the big players sometimes don't see him. They bring that ball down to him, boom, he swipes at it.
So it is Navy ball. Missouri pressing and Booker saying that enough.
Well, it's interesting, too, that Don DeVoe has Brian Walker taking the ball out of bounds. You think he'd have somebody else taking the ball out of bounds and having Walker come off a pick to set him up to get the ball to bring it down court.
Yeah, that occurred to me. Perhaps now that they've seen this press down here, they may make a change.
Well, the last three possessions, they've kept the ball out of Brian Walker's hands.
Missouri ball, Booker. Marco Finner, number 21, the junior forward of the game. He missed it, rebounded by Navy. We're still tied at 11. Jim Hamilton, the sophomore from Erie, Pennsylvania, connects for the Naval Academy in a three-pointer. That's his specialty.
Well, you think that's the kind of game Missouri would like, is to kind of pick this pace up a little bit. Maybe feeling that Navy can't stay with them and take some quick shots.
Substitution, number zero, Jamal Crudo.
Maybe the tempo of this game has been set basically by the clock in the very beginning. Torgrimson, a freshman coming in.
Randy Torgrimson from West Fargo, North Dakota. His brother is also on the roster. Walker and Torgrimson. Now the backcourt for Navy. Bugrumson. Rebound Cooper, and Cooper hits. The junior from Woodbridge, Virginia, averaging just under 10 a game, connects for Navy and a 5-point lead, widest of this first half.
Very low scoring game. Both these teams average over 75 points a game. Missouri seems really out of sync in this game. No flow, just kind of struggling.
Thames, the freshman, yes.
He's not struggling.
16-13, 7 points for Thames.
Little push from behind, Kelly Thames getting caught, his first personal. He was a Big Eight Freshman of the Year this year.
That is the third team foul.
Hamilton.
I tell you, he sure has a strange release. It almost comes off sideways.
Missouri player control foul, number 15, Calvin Booker. His first personal foul.
Booker picks up his first foul.
That is the fourth Missouri.
Well, for number one seed, they really don't look sharp right now.
Fourth team foul on Missouri. Hamilton driving, yes.
Number 32, Jim Hamilton.
Your basic layup.
18-13, 5 points for Hamilton. Crudup outside, gets it underneath for Thames. He can't drop it.
I think that's where the Tigers really have to keep attacking the midshipmen, going inside, and trying to get some offensive boards if they miss that first shot. Because even if they miss, they go to the free throw line. If you're going to create contact, and they've got the big guys to do it.
Alden Booker back the other way for Missouri. Inside to Crudup, and Crudup hits.
Field goal, nice hook
shot. Javon Crudup, a 6'9 senior from Kansas City. He's got 3 points.
And when Missouri scores that quickly, it kind of picks up the tempo a little bit.
Conan missing. Frazier knocked it out of bounds. Off the hands of a Navy player, it'll be Frazier inbounding for Missouri.
This is the quickest that the Tigers have gotten into their offense to shoot the basketball going inside to Crudup.
Sutherland in the corner, watched by Torgrimson. Crudup inside again over Conan.
Field goal by Javon Crudup.
5 points now for Crudup. 1 point Navy margin. Cooper flattened his defender.
I tell you, Kelly Thames does a pretty good acting job, too. Once the contact was made, he really did a flop, but good call by the official.
So with a timeout, it's a 1-point Navy lead. 7:16 to go, first half.
The Women's Final Four, coming soon on CBS.
Every one of them demands something different from their Chevy truck, but they all want the same thing. The most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Bring those cheese and flavor. Tennessee's your corner saver.
Once you pop, you
can't stop.
This is the award-winning Goodyear AquaTread with its deep groove aqua channel. And this is the new Eagle AquaTread for performance sedans. A wider performance tire with two aqua channels to sweep water away. Now you get the wet traction of a Goodyear AquaTread and the performance of a Goodyear Eagle. One good turn deserves another. The new Eagle AquaTread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
Gulf of Mexico, where world-class fishermen like Jim come to battle the big boys.
Jim, you've got one.
Yeah, hey, this calls for a celebration. How about a cold O'Doul?
Thanks.
Ah, only 70 calories and not alcohol, because out here, you never know what's biting.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without all the alcohol, think O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
All right, with Navy up a point, let's squeeze in a look around the country at the other three sites. Jim Nantz, Clark Kellogg from New York, First Michigan in the gold, playing against Pepperdine. And what's the story in this one, Clark? Seven or a minute and a half to go first half, and Michigan's lead is five.
Well, the maize and blue Wolverines dominating action in the paint. Juwan Howard has 16, 7-9 shooting. They've got 30 points in the paint area.
Look at the Waves. They're back within three with a little more than a minute to go first half. Meanwhile, Penn and Nebraska, some hot action in this one. 12 minutes to go, and that's Penn in the red leading by 12.
Well, if we were in the hood, Jim, they'd talk about these guys hooping because Penn is playing excellent basketball. They've made seven of 23-point field goals. And they just continue to thwart every rally that Nebraska makes by knocking down crucial three-point shots.
So they're headed to a break with Penn up 14, bound to perhaps beat the sixth seed in the East. Now, Central Florida and Purdue, and Mr. Robinson starting to heat up. It's a 22-point lead for Purdue with 12 minutes to go in the game.
Time to put it on cruise control. Walk it on in. This one's over.
He's up to 21 now in the game as Boilermakers lead. Again, with 12 minutes remaining. They're the one seed in the Southeast. Let's head back out to the one seed in the West, Missouri against Navy, and back to Tim and Ann.
Thank you, Jim. It is a one-point game, Navy 18-17. Walker brings it up. We have 7:03 to go in the first half. Walker watched by Sutherland. Pass inside. He saved it momentarily, and there's a foul along the baseline.
They're going to call a push on Julian Winfield.
Winfield's second.
Missouri personal foul.
Yeah, you talk about Brian Walker's ball handling. The one thing, he is a freshman. He does make a lot of mistakes, and with maturity and as he goes along, he'll be a lot more confident as far as scoring. And that is what's hard, is that he is not an offensive threat. He's got to try it, and he's not a great penetrator because he's not going to look for a shot. And sometimes that does hurt you a little bit because he doesn't get in the flow of the offense.
That miss from Brad Copper, senior from Kellogg, Idaho. And the score remains a point margin for the Naval Academy at 6:20 to go in the first half.
See if Missouri continues to go inside to Cuda.
Thames drives to the line, misses his shot. Rebounded by Hamilton.
Oh, what a great shot. Good follow by Cooper, but a super shot by number 34, Coffer.
20-17. Lamont Frazier. Krutoff. And Krutoff is fouled as he goes to the hoop.
Personal foul. Number 34.
Here's a pass in. See the pass inside. And underneath, Copper just can't get quite there to use the board, but Cooper has a good follow.
Putting Missouri into the bonus.
17 fouls on Navy. Put him at the line on his shooting foul.
Shooting one.
And a three-point lead for the midshipmen here with 5:50 to go in the first half. They are the number 16 seed here, remember, against number one, Missouri, number one in the West.
Number 10, Chip Walter. Number 25, Jeff Frost. Number 4, Reggie
Norton Smith. Stewart feels that Javon Crudup is the best post-defensive player that he has ever had.
Match up, everybody match up. Crudup at 6'9 and a big guy. Jed Frost has come in the lineup, number 25, a senior guard from Kansas City for Missouri.
A lot of substitutions, and Navy was asking to match up.
And Reggie Smith, the senior guard from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, number 4, also in for Missouri. And yet another, Chip Walter, number 10, a freshman from St. Louis. Crudup with 6 points, going for 7. And he hits. That brings in number 21, Marlo Finner, who was in briefly earlier in this first half, a junior from Chicago. So Norm Stewart, with 5:50 to go in the half, has got all fresh legs in here.
And he relies on his bench an awful lot. His bench averages 26 points.
Chris Heller, number 41, is at center, a senior from Kansas City.
Missouri ball.
That'll be Missouri ball. So a completely new lineup now for Missouri.
Cross
for Heller. Heller missed the shot. Cooper on the rebound and Walker down court quickly. Walker trying to penetrate, perhaps thinking he can do it against the second team unit. He's had no success against the first. That's Copper. 22-19, his first points.
You know, a couple possessions when they went inside to Crudup, you felt that Missouri started to get things going and maybe had control, but Navy definitely is pesty and they're staying right in there.
Smith driving the baseline.
Missouri.
Ball knocked out of bounds. Missouri ball. 4:44 remaining. Stewart getting ready to substitute again as Finner missed his shot. Marlo Finner, number 21. Stewart has 4 players up ready to come in for Missouri. Finner will be going to the line.
Navy personal foul, number 40, Wes Cooper.
Norm Stewart looking over what's going on at the free throw line and talking to his players. He's got to be a little concerned about the way his team is playing right now.
Cooper has picked up that foul, his second, and Finner misses the first free throw.
I'm sorry, Tim. They look a little lethargic. They just are not clicking. Things aren't flowing for them, and hopefully he's sending in 4 of his top 5 guys to come back in. They're going to sit back down.
Finner hits the second one to bring the margin to 2, Navy by 2. Rodrumson, his pass picked off by Smith. And Smith is fouled as he goes up. Jim Hamilton fouling Smith. Reggie Smith, the senior.
The other thing with Norm Stewart putting this lineup in, too, Tim, is the fact that maybe he's trying to do something different. If the starters aren't going to do it, put the subs in and see if they can get some fire and get something clicking. And Smith coming in with a big steal, and he's going to go to the free throw line.
Reggie Smith had been a starter for Missouri. Bothered by injuries, coming back slowly from those, and they don't feel he's quite in full game shape, but getting some time here on this last 5 minutes of the first half.
Well, he sprained that left ankle in the Arkansas game, and he missed 6 games. As you said, he's still kind of conditioning himself.
You can see he's got a big kind of a brace around the left ankle. Well above the shoe top.
You're not giving anything away with Reggie Smith, the 6'2 senior.
He's tied it at 22 with 4:25 to go first half. number 16 Navy, hoping they can duplicate the feat. Wisconsin Green Bay who knocked out California Golden Bears this afternoon here in Ogden. Hanging tough with number one. And that is in and out off the hands of Jim Hamilton. Jumper wouldn't drop for him, and Smith back to Missouri. Marlo Finner, documented travel off to Smith.
Norm Stewart felt that three-point shots were going to be a key for his team to get victories.
4 points for Marlo Finner and a hold called. That is Keller picking up his first foul.
His first personal foul.
16 fouls on Missouri. They'll make it seven.
This is not one of the strengths of the midshipmen going to the free throw line. They average 25 shots at the line, but they're only a 63% free throw shooter, last in the Patriot League.
Alex Conan at the line, the St. Louis sophomore. It's the first. Conan averages 8.4 points a game. And it is a one-point margin for Missouri. 3:35 remaining first half.
In the preseason, I don't get out much. But come spring, there's nothing more relaxing than a little walk in the park.
All men are created equal. Some just work harder in the preseason.
So, does it ever get any easier?
I don't think it's supposed to. It's a sophisticated flight simulator. But around here, we call it the box. Even though it doesn't fly, it's sure going to test how well you can. At American, we come here twice a year to get checked out. You know, I don't know of another airline that puts more emphasis on training.
See you in 6 months.
Oh, I'll be back.
But if you happen to be sitting behind me,
good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
I bet you'll agree. Welcome you aboard American Airlines. It's worth it.
There are over 3 million miles of roads in America. And if you're on any one of them, Chevrolet will be there. Our genuine customer care program will take care of you with a 3-year, 36,000-mile warranty, 24-hour roadside assistance, 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion protection, free courtesy transportation if your car ever needs service, and the largest dealer network in the country. That's genuine customer care. Genuine Chevrolet.
Introducing the Quantum Random Orbit Sander. It works 4 times faster than a finishing sander with swirl-free results. So now you can tackle any project from start to finish. The new Quantum line from Black & Decker.
Chances are it will outlast your car and your furnace and your roof. There's no telling what your Moen faucet might outlast. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
A new breed of cop.
Chris Trapjack.
With a powerful ally.
Fire him or support him.
Or else.
Or else I'm going to tip your desk over on you.
Thursdays, get set for Traps.
Well, so far, one of the highlights of the game has been 7 shot clock malfunctions here between Navy and Missouri. Hall off to a good start for the Naval Academy, and they trail the Tigers by 1. And Norm Stewart is sticking with this second unit he brought in with about 5 minutes remaining in the half. This is Smith.
And the clock definitely set the tempo of the game.
Reggie Smith off of Walter. Finner, Marlo Finner hits for 3. So he has widened the lead for Missouri, 28-24.
Finner has hit 2 3-pointers for the Tigers.
7 points for Finner. Ryan Walker, the 5'8 guard, has been unable to make anything happen of significance for the Naval Academy. And there's a steal on a return pass from Hall and a foul.
Navy personal foul.
Walker picks up his second.
His second personal foul. That's the third team foul.
Walter will go to the line for Missouri with 2:45 to go here in the first half, and a 4-point Tiger lead.
At the free throw line, number 10, Chip Walter.
And Norm Stewart evidently is going to finish the half with his second unit. Missouri starting off very sluggishly in this basketball game, and this unit has sparked him at least to the 4-point lead they presently have. Walter with the second shot. Chip Walter, a freshman from St. Louis, 29-24. Ryan Torgrimson, brother of Randy, now in the ball game for Navy.
Good heads up play by Heller on that block shot. Nice pass. They don't call the charge off. Really delayed. They call a travel.
Travel called against Frost. Jed Frost.
I tell you, the Missouri bench cheering the five players out on the court on. Everybody's standing.
Pogrom's in the hall. To Conan. Conan is shot is blocked by Heller. Chris Heller, a sometime starter, is joined the second unit in their little resurgence here in this last 5 minutes of the half for Missouri.
His second block, he had 15 blocks coming into this game. He's only averaging 8 minutes a game.
Reggie Smith missing and rebound. Taken down by Jim Hamilton, and Hamilton off the back iron. Navy controls. And Hall is fouled by Smith.
Navy does a good job getting the ball inside to Conan. Conan with a little pump fake goes in and goes back to his right hand. Can't use that little left hand, and Heller's right there to knock it away.
Perfectly timed block. Meanwhile, Hall will go to the line.
Navy, number 20, Randy Torgrimson. At the free throw line, number 12, T.J. Hall. Shooting one block.
Jim Hamilton goes out. Navy, 10 points now for Hall. Brad Copper's back into the Naval Academy lineup. Finner rebounding on the miss from Hall. 29-25, Missouri lead.
Coming into this game, Navy has won 7 in a row, so they've got to be pretty confident going into halftime. Little deflection right there.
Reggie Smith sets up a new play for the Tigers of Missouri. Finner for 3, in and out. He's made 2 of those already.
That's going to be a key for Navy. If they can keep rebounding against Missouri, they'll come down, keep Missouri off the boards, who is the bigger team.
Ryan Torgrimson off to his brother Randy.
Another block by Heller. They're going to call a foul that time, but Missouri did a good job collapsing on Conan. Conan really didn't have anywhere to go, and he just kept pivoting and pivoting, and good heads-up play, but they called the foul.
First on Finner. Alex Conan, sophomore to the line, 6'11", at the tallest of the Naval Academy players.
An aerospace engineer major. Kind of like David Robinson, he's not going into any subs. Of course, this guy might.
He'd have trouble fitting into a lot of things. Yeah, well, Walker can fit into anything. Frost goes out. And Thames comes back in along with Booker. In the final minute, Norm Stewart sends 2 of his starters back out there. Booker and Thames. Norm Stewart has got to be happy to have the depth that he has with his team this year. Experienced players and backup guys, 2 seniors and 2 juniors.
Great hustle by T.J. Hall. Goes off of Thames' foot, and Navy keeps it.
The late spurt by Missouri came from the bench. They lead by 3, 54 seconds left. Ryan Torgrimson. Watched closely by Walter. And his brother Randy off the mark. Walter back, he thought Frazier was in the corner. Frazier was cutting to the basket.
Well, Frazier usually is a guard handling the ball, and Walter coming back out of the game, Kruda coming in for him, and Frazier was just going down to set a pick.
So now Smith, Booker, Frazier, Thames, and Kruda. The lineup for Norm Stewart's Missouri Tigers. Final seconds of the first half. Torgrimson to Hall. Hall trying to blast down the middle. He misses. And the rebound is taken by Thames. Final shot will be Missouri's. They lead by three. Reggie Smith works his way in. Missed it. Rebounded by Navy's Conan. And the buzzer sounds. But the Missouri Tigers holding a three-point margin, the number one seed in the West, and they can't feel too good about that. It was a very struggling first half for the top seed. That's the end of the first half of the score. Missouri 29, Navy 26. Jim Nancy, Clark Kellogg will be along. Pennzoil at the half after the message.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the first round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Domino's Pizza, Moyne Faucets, and by Reebok.
The standard set by the federal government requires that a car with two airbags must help protect two passengers, ignoring the center seat passenger. The higher standard in the all-new DeVille by Cadillac. An airbank system which provides supplemental protection for not one, not two, but all three front seat passengers. The airbank system in the new V8-powered DeVille by Cadillac. Creating a higher standard.
College can be a bridge to the future. It's a place where you're free to express yourself. A time to find out what you're really capable of. But when testing your limits involves alcohol, when breaking away includes drinking and driving, when expressing yourself includes losing control, the lessons you learn in college may not help you get anywhere at all.
This is CBS.
$10 for a 2x4?
Real wood costs money.
But it's warped.
That's how you can tell it's real wood.
Paying too much for too little? It's HQ to the rescue. Introducing Home Quarters, the biggest, most complete home improvement warehouse with the widest selection, best service, and guaranteed lowest prices. So keep a lookout for the new HQ.
And we'll keep looking out for you.
Most golfers try to stay out of the rough, but in truck golf...
The rough! Yes!
There's no rough rough enough.
Excellent!
But don't venture out onto the course without one of these. 1994 Ford Ranger 4x4.
Sweet!
Complete with push-button four-wheel drive, a wide, powerful stance, and a whopping 4-liter V6. Get a Ford Ranger 4x4 and get into the swing of truck golf. But remember, always replace your divots.
All right, the Middies and Missouri. Three-point lead for the Tigers at halftime. Three other games in the second half. We'll check them out in a moment.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
All right, welcome back to New York. Jim Nance along with Clark Kellogg here on St. Patrick's Day night. And good action, Navy and Missouri. And how about this game, the way the Middies are playing?
Well, they're hanging in pretty tough. Missouri really wins with ugly, physical, tough defense. So you expect a low-scoring game, and Navy going tit for tat with Missouri right now.
Yeah, 29-26 in that one. And let's check out some of the other scores. Here's a one seed, the one seed in the Southeast. Just pulling away now, 93-59, 2 minutes to go in that game. Glenn Robinson has been taken out just a short while ago. 31 points, 11 rebounds for the likely player of the year in college basketball. 93-59, Purdue will advance to the second round. Now, Michigan and Pepperdine, they're in a timeout there at Wichita.
And Michigan leading 43-32. They scored the first 4 points of the second half, Clark. And this was 35-32 just a few minutes before halftime. So that's 8 unanswered now for the Wolverines.
Well, Michigan really exerting themselves inside. When you've got an efficient post player like Juwan Howard, let him touch it and let him get to work. And that's exactly what the Wolverines are doing.
Well, in fact, to support that, 26 points in the paint for Michigan, only 10 for Pepperdine. All right, they've resumed play, so let's go out there now and join our announcers, Sean McDonough and Derek Dickey.
Derek Noether with the left-hander for Pepperdine. Get the deficit back into single digits. The Waves down 9. And the steal by Jones.
Pepperdine is now starting to be aggressive the way they were early in the game. They came out assertive, took the ball right to the basket, not afraid of the Wolverines, looked for the shot down in the low block, pitched it back out, tried to get some layups, tried to get some three-point shots, unable to do it. But Howard has been the story in this game. Juwan Howard, 20 points in the first half in 17 minutes, 4 rebounds.
Pepperdine jumped off to the early lead, led by as many as 5 early. They need to get a shot off here. Lopez launches a 3 and got it. What a shot as the shot clock expired by Damon Lopez.
That may be the kind of spark that the Waves need to get back in this game. They're playing good defense, except giving up a Swiss cheese, a hole in the perimeter, the interior defense for an easy layup for Michigan.
Rose off to Howard. First points of the second half for Juwan. He has 22. The Michigan lead is 8. This game was close early on. There were 5 ties in the first half. The game hasn't been tied since it was 15 all. Howard called for climbing the back of Noether. And that's Juwan's 3rd, a potential problem for the Wolverines.
Shot clock running down. Damon Lopez going through his ritual as he shoots the ball off balance and touching his forehead and both heels. This is a routine that he goes through after he makes a 3-point basket.
And Michigan doubles the low post. Noether broke free. That ball appeared to be on the rim when James swatted it. Fife came away from the pack with it. Rose tries to push but couldn't shed Dana Jones. Jones the steal. Rose gave him the head and shoulder fake and Jones didn't go for it. Now he's nodding in the forecourt as if to say, yep, I just took it away from Jalen Rose.
Dana Jones is displaying some excellent quickness on the offensive glass and now with the quick hands and the steal. Jalen Rose is going to try to give him this familiar head and shoulder fake and Jones does not go for it and able to come up with a pick of the pocket.
There's the 3rd foul on Ray Jackson. Olivier St. Jean back into the game. Michigan leads by 8. Jackson has taken a seat on the bench with his 3 fouls. Juwan Howard is playing with his 3. Penn still leads Nebraska. Lakers have led virtually throughout. Purdue pulling away from Central Florida. Missouri winning a real battle for Navy. Wisconsin Green Bay with the first big upset of the day. And I'm not sure that's that big an upset that Bennett's club. Always pesky, it seems. Lopez bounced into traffic, kicked it out, wide open 3. Got it! Brian Parker.
Excellent dribble penetration by Damon Lopez to draw the Michigan defense inside. Pitch it back out for the open 3.
Well, the big question will be, can Pepperdine stop Michigan inside? The Wolverines go outside. Fife missed it. Howard, it's just too easy for Juwan Howard.
Juwan Howard using every bit of that 6'9" frame to dominate the inside, getting easy layups either on direct passes or on offensive stick backs.
Michigan by 7. 14 and a half minutes remaining here in Wichita. Fife runs out to guard Lopez.
Cannot afford to leave Lopez for 1 minute.
Mentioned earlier, he's 135 pounds. Coach Asbury said, pound for pound, he's the best player in the country, but unfortunately, he doesn't weigh enough. Rose down the lane, dished it off to Howard. He missed the short one. Lopez, Fife right there to play him at the 3-point line. Parker open. He feels it. couple of three-pointers in succession for Brian Parker, and all of a sudden the Waves are within four.
The Waves are just taking advantage of Michigan not getting back on defense.
Rose didn't get the bounce, but he did draw a foul from Derek Noether. That's the third on Noether, and Rose will shoot two. Gerald Brown comes into the game for Pepperdine, and Damon Lopez will take a seat. Gavin Vanderputten is also coming back in for the Waves, and Noether goes to the bench with his three personals.
In the first half, we saw Michigan just dominate the inside on the offensive glass as well as scoring. And now they're trying to get back to that, get the penetration, also get the ball down in transition and get the easy layup before the Waves get their defense set.
As you can see, it has not been a terrific night for Jalen Rose. Only 2 points, 1 of 5 from the floor. Jalen has been in double figures in scoring and 27 out of 28 games this year. Held to 9 points in the game at Purdue.
All right, so that's a 5-point Michigan lead in the second half. We'll keep you posted on that game. And Clark, an upset in the East about to be finalized. 30 seconds to go. And Penn, the 11th seed, leads the 6th seed Nebraska by 10, 86-76. Again, 31 seconds to go. A 6th seed about to be ousted. A 5 earlier today. Cal out west was knocked out of the tournament. Second half coming up for Navy and Missouri. Thanks for watching Penn's Oil at the Half on the road to the Final Four.
Penn's Oil at the Half was sponsored by Penn's Oil, the motor oil you can rely on for performance, protection, and quality.
Get two medium, two-topping thin crust pizzas, just $12.99. Plus 3 months of Showtime free.
It's a hot deal. It's a cool deal. A Domino's. I want it. I need it. Deal.
Two medium, two-topping thin crust pizzas, just $12.99. Plus 3 months of great entertainment on Showtime free.
Something for nothing when you call Domino's.
About 65 miles south of the nearest stoplight, and 2 miles up in the Rocky Mountain sky, you'll find Skier's Heaven, also known as Telluride Ski Mountain, where the skiing's perfect and the views are even better. And whether you're going to extremes or just going for a lesson, don't go without your Visa card, because at Telluride Ski Mountain, they'll let you take the plunge, but they won't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Both education and recreation are essential for a healthy life. Now the children in your community can learn the physical and mental skills they will need for success in sports and in school from college coaches and student athletes. Youth education through sports, or YES clinics, are offered free of charge at NCAA Championship.
Just teaching basic concepts.
The NCAA, its corporate partners, and the NCAA member schools in your community provide sponsorship for the YES program, now in its 7th year.
Yes!
If you're in high school and you want to play sports at an NCAA Division I or II school, you must be certified by the NCAA Initial Eligibility Clearinghouse. Ask your coach or guidance counselor for one of these student release forms, fill it out, and send it to the clearinghouse. Remember, if you're not certified, you can't compete as a freshman in NCAA Division I or II. For more information, call 319-337-1492.
Marlo Thomas, Mel Harris, and Ali Sheedy.
My dad did unspeakable things to us.
Sisters face their past and expose the ultimate betrayal Sunday.
Back here in Ogden, Utah, Missouri with a 3-point lead over Navy. They got their subs off the bench with 5 minutes to go in the half. Came from down 3 and are now up 3. And we'll be back to play the second half in a moment.
Play could get you to the Final Four. Game cards are inside specially marked cases of Pennzoil motor oil. Or will you get your oil changed professionally with Pennzoil? Scratch, match, and win one of 4 trips for 2 to the Final Four in 94 or 95. Or any of 10,000 other prizes. What a slam fest this is going to be. So fans, get your Pennzoil now and...
You've got the winning color!
Oh man, what a game!
Look
who's living in Archie Bunker's house now.
You are a bigot.
Black man can't be a bigot, son.
Tell that to a Korean, Dad.
Some things never change.
We have too many children having children.
You just might be right on that one, son. Because I know one too many that I had.
From the creator of All in the Family, there's an all-new family.
Women are looking for someone who'll say I do. Men want anybody to say I will.
704 Houser premieres Monday, April 11th.
This is CBS.
It's on.
March Madness. One station. 64 teams. Total coverage. For the most complete reports on your favorite teams, keep it tuned to News 5. Coverage of March Madness is brought to you by Miller Lite. NCAA bracket charts available where Miller Lite is sold.
BMW and Mercedes may say their cars walk on water, yet perhaps their owners would disagree. Nearly 2 out of 3 when replacing their cars chose something else. Lexus, however, has the highest repurchase rate of any luxury car line. So before you buy one of them, check with someone who's already gotten their feet wet. Whether you buy or lease, see the LS at Superior Lexus.
Missouri 29, Navy 26 as we begin the second half. And for a report, let's go to Jim Gray.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. The Missouri Tiger locker room was very quiet, all except for Norm Stewart. He was very upset with what went on in the first half. When he came out, I asked him what they planned to do different in the second half. He said, we're going to try and play this half because we certainly didn't play at all in the first half. He said he didn't like the pace, didn't like anything about it. Went to the second unit to try and shake up the first unit. He says he will start the first unit in the second half, but they'll be back on the bench if they're as bad as they were in the first. Tim?
Well, one thing about Norm, he doesn't mince words. He kind of said it, and here's what he was upset about.
Well, you see, Missouri, the shots that they're getting a lot of shots inside, and they're just not making them, shooting 36% in that first half.
Well, he has done this before, changing whole units, but not so much this season. And I'm sure it came as a bit of a shock to his team. Of course, remember, they went 14-0 in the Big 8. He wouldn't have too many occasions to try and shake them up like that. This team is number one seed, 25 victories, only 3 defeats. Let's see what happens here in half number 2. They are in front by 3. Number 16-seeded Navy midshipman having to come from behind, and Kudup took it right away.
And that's the one guy that really has to come out and play inside, and also they do it. Start running in the beginning.
Well, there's more of the Missouri luck. Perfect alley-ooper, and Thames, the freshman, buries it.
Obviously, the tempo, a big difference coming out, having to run the basketball, and you can do that when you can play defense.
This is Hall. He's been the main man for Navy in the first half. 10 points, missing there, and Missouri rebounding again.
Navy really was able in that first half to stay on the boards with Missouri. Missouri has to start hitting the boards. Good up with 3 rebounds already.
Good up quickly outside to Thames.
Kudup leads his team in rebounding. Only had 1 in the first half.
Booker trying the baseline. Walker forces him out.
I guess you have to yell to kind of fire yourself up, too, on those rebounds.
Thames, turnaround hook, drops for the freshman. 6'7" freshman from Jennings, Missouri. Navy has missed their last 9 shots from the field, and they need this little guy, Brian Walker, to make something happen. He was not a factor in the first half. Walker now comes up with a loose ball, penetrating in the lane, off to Conan. Conan took off the iron. Rebound, Kudup.
Kudup was yelling before he got that rebound.
Kudup. Booker rebound. Walker got a hand on it to knock it out.
Obviously a big difference in this second half, Tim, with Missouri coming out. They're just totally different attitude. I mean, they're fired up. They're out here to play. They're not walking the ball up. They're not in slow motion. They almost look like they were in quicksand in that first half and really picking things up. So it would have been interesting to be a little fly in that locker room with Norm Stewart.
Coleman rebounds for the middies, and it is Hall. And he's whacked by Booker, who picks up the foul. His second, Melvin Booker, the senior.
Personal foul, number 15, Melvin Booker.
Navy continually has to try and slow the pace down. They've got to try and hit the boards. It's going to be tough with Missouri if they've picked up their intensity screening out. But Navy has to try and get the ball inside to Conan and be very patient on their offense.
7-point lead for the number one seeded Tigers.
And that's where at 5-8 right now, Brian Walker gets caught behind the pick, and he's got to be able to take that shot.
And Krunup whoops again and comes away with the ball.
I don't know whether he's in pain or has gas.
Javon Krunup, a vocal senior from Kansas City.
Passes are a lot quicker for the Tigers in the second half. Better ball movement, better shot selections.
Well, credit Norm Stewart's wake-up call, sending the second unit in 5 minutes to go in the first half. They got them a 3-point lead, and they now lead by 7 with the starters back in.
Navy, a very young team. One senior. As we mentioned, that they do have a junior varsity team.
Walker's jumper well short, an air ball.
And one of their freshmen, Brian Walker, good shot. Because he doesn't look at the basket that much, he shoots balls like that, and I think that's going to be a big difference in his game next year if he works on it this summer, as far as being an offensive player, being able to attack and have somebody guard him where he's going to score or go to the free throw line.
Don DeVoe is going to sit him down after that air ball. He's got Randy Torgrimson, number 20, in, one of the two Torgrimson brothers, also a freshman. He's number 20. Near steal by Hall has been the main man here.
Good catch, Tim.
For the Naval Academy.
Missouri, first of all, number 22.
Well, Pennsylvania has upset Nebraska, advancing over the Big 8 tournament champion. Nebraska, of course, beat Missouri in the final of the Big 8 tournament and got into the NCAA, but Pennsylvania, the Ivy League champs, have knocked them out.
Also, George Washington, a number 10 seed, beating University of Alabama.
Torgrimson driving. 33-28, a 5-point margin. Winfield inside for Krunup.
Missouri,
is that George Washington
five.
Final, 51-46. Over UAB. Frazier inbounding for Missouri. Gets it right back from Winfield. Sutherland. Rebounded by Torgrimson. In and out. Thames rebounds for Missouri. 2-on-2. Winfield tried to hold up on the jump, but he had too much forward motion going, and Navy rebounding.
Well, also you had Alex Conan at 6'11 just putting his arms up, making him stop.
Cooper on the baseline, back out for Hall. He's short, follows his own shot, and drops the rebound.
Good follow by T.J. Hall. A lot of his shots we've seen in the first half, and maybe in the second half, legs aren't completely there. He's had that strep throat for the last couple days.
The leading scorer, a junior from Port Jefferson, New York. 21 points in the win over Colgate in the Patriot Conference Tournament Final.
That was a nice pass by Krunup down low.
Cooper came away with it for Navy. Trailing by 3. Number 16 seeds not going away from the top-seeded Tigers. Dogrums in the Hall. And it's rebounded on Hall's shot by Frazier. Frazier's pass. 3 players diving for it. Came right back to Frazier. kind of both Crudup and Thames missed the opportunity, but a foul underneath.
T.J. Hall went down hard, diving for that ball at the half-court line. Sometimes, you know, when you're sick, you have a tendency to play a lot better because you concentrate. And you know that you need as much energy as you can have. And he, even though T.J. Hall, his shots are short from the outside, he's making things happen defensively. He's got very quick hands. He comes up from behind and looks for steals. And but he's also penetrating to the basket offensively.
Conan goes out for Navy. Copper comes in, number 34. Copper is a 6'8 senior from Kellogg, Idaho.
At the free throw line, number 33, Billy Vance.
Atkins is in for Missouri. Mark Atkins, number 3, a senior from Gary, Indiana. And Thames missing from the free throw line.
Kelly Thames, coming out of high school in Missouri, was voted Mr. Basketball.
And misses them both. It remains 33-30, Missouri. Gorgensen, Cooper, Hall. Jim Hamilton for Navy. And Copper. Copper shot knocked out of bounds.
Timeout on the floor.
And timeout on the floor with 14:05 remaining in the second half. Missouri by 3.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the first round of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Mazda, Heineken, and by Pennzoil Motor Oil.
The Women's Final Four, coming soon on CBS.
They say money will buy more in the new millennium. They say luxury will endure in the new millennium. They even say a car that competes with Lexus and Mercedes can be priced from $26,000 when you're not asked to pay for a luxury division and all that overhead. The new $26,000 millennium from Mazda.
Just a reminder, if you're talking basketball, Foot Locker speaks your language. Well, most of it. Foot Locker, official corporate partner for the NCAA championships.
The forecast called for a calm, quiet meeting, but a tempest rages instead. It's often the case in today's international business climate. Which is why we prepare to place high above it all with worldly comforts that refresh, restore, and renew. United Airlines, the calm before and after the storm. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
Want to give your best friend a big laugh? Phone MCI at 1-800-933-6333 and let one of these CBS stars do it for you, for free. Any friend, anytime. Really. So call and send a laugh to your best friend from CBS and MCI. It's free.
Well, in the Southeast region, the number one seed there, Purdue, got by Central Florida quite easily, along with Wake Forest and Kansas. But number one here on the West, Missouri, being battled by Navy, leading only by 3 are the Tigers, 14 minutes to go. Hamilton hit, three-pointer.
Well, he's got that knuckleball or something. He's got great rotation, but he shoots it from the side.
8 points for Hamilton, and we're tied again. Hamilton, a sophomore from Erie, Pennsylvania. 72 three-pointers coming into this game, and he's added two more. Maybe back the other way. Pergrimson, in and out. Smith battling for the rebound. He's tied up, and they're going to call a foul on Copper. Number 34, Brad Copper.
Personal foul, number 34, Brad Copper.
Inside this second half, the guards are the ones that have been rebounding for the Tigers. Melvin Booker coming into the game, averaging over 17 points. 27 games he has had double figures. Only one game this year against Oklahoma he has scored single figures. 5 points, he's only got three in this game.
Thames hits from outside. 13 points for the freshman. 35-33, Missouri. Paul, watched by Jason Sutherland. Targram's in inside for Copper. His hook off the front iron. Thames rebounding. Booker, Missouri on the run. Booker into the lane off the back iron, and it's rebounded by Hamilton. By Hall, pardon me. Number 12, T.J. Hall.
Navy in their half-court game, slowing things down. Also, Missouri picking up the intensity in their defense.
Hall can't get the shot away, blocked nicely by Sutherland. Sutherland for Booker. Four-point Missouri lead.
That's what the Tigers want to do, is run, and they can run if they play good defense.
Nice moves by Hamilton, then lost control, but it's kept in by Torgrimson.
Well, somebody was open, and the Navy just throws it away.
An errant pass by Randy Torgrimson. And with 11:56 to go, the Tigers lead by four.
Next week is my fifth wedding anniversary. It's unbelievable how time flies.
Did you get her a present yet?
Yeah, I'm getting her a really nice washer and dryer.
Oh, come on. She'll never forgive you. You gotta get her something for her.
It is for her.
No blondes in bikinis.
Get a jewel.
No sales pitch from the chairman.
Or vacation.
None of that is what made Heineken the number one imported beer in America.
You think I should take her someplace special?
Definitely.
So maybe I'll take her to Cooperstown.
No.
Even with dual airbags, power windows, air conditioning, cruise control, and a powerful six-cylinder engine, the Mazda 626 still costs less than a four-cylinder Camry LE. So while owning a 626 isn't exactly a license to print money, it can save you a mint, to coin a phrase.
Real quality, real fit. No wonder guys feel comfortable with Jockey. Genuine Jockey, yeah!
From Gillette comes a revolutionary form of antiperspirant protection. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. Because it's a clear, clean, powerful gel, it goes on smoothly with no white residue to form an invisible barrier of protection. All-day protection against both wetness and odor. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. One of the advanced deodorants and antiperspirants in the Gillette series.
Our barbecue chicken sandwich is a hit. Folks love our tangy honey barbecue sauce.
Russ, $1.49 barbecue chicken sandwich forever.
Not quite. The $1.49 is for a limited time.
We do chicken right.
He's tired of the crime. And when they come after his family,
then he'd kill us both.
He's tired of playing by the rules. Steven Seagal, marked for death Tuesday, contains some violent scenes.
Well, the Cincinnati Bearcats heading to the locker room to get ready for the final game of four here in Ogden, Utah. They'll take on the Wisconsin Badgers, the number nine seeds. Cincinnati, number eight. That's upcoming, our final game. From Ogden, Utah, in round number one of the West region here. Missouri leading 37-33 over Navy. And that is off the rim from Mark Atkins. Walker back out there now, the freshman guard for Navy. Cooper to Hall. Hamilton, a three-pointer. 11 points for him, 75 three-pointers. A Navy record. for Jim Hamilton.
He shoots 43% from three-point range.
Booker, beautiful shot.
Booker, it seems like in the second half coming in, might try and take advantage now of his height at 6'2 over Brian Walker at 5'8.
Hall in the traffic.
No foul.
No call. Walker's speed inside for Conan, and Conan lost it. 2-on-1. Booker over Walker. Booker. 41-36, 5-point Missouri lead, 10:25 to go.
Well, T.J. Hall, he likes to penetrate. He goes to the free throw line an awful lot of times. That time he doesn't get it.
Conan's turnaround off the glass.
Could have did a good job, Tim, as far as defense was concerned. He pushed Conan out away from the basket a little bit further than he would like to take that shot.
Sutherland's jumper from three. Atkins gets the rebound from Missouri.
Long shot, long rebound.
Thames. Yelly, Thames now 15 points.
Missouri's starting to pull away a little bit of breathing room.
7-point lead. Brian Walker's first points of the game. Rebound by Navy's Hamilton. Quickly to Walker. Walker driving, trying to get down the lane. And it'll be Missouri ball.
Navy substitution, number 34, Brian Copper. Your attention, please. Todd Jorgensen, meet your wife at Portal 9.
T.J. Hall with 12 points in the last three games in the tournament. The Patriot League, he was the tournament MVP, averaging 25 points.
To 39, and Walker knocks it loose, but it's recovered by Missouri. Booker for Atkins. Kuda in traffic, but makes the play over Conan. 45-39, Tigers, 9 points.
I should say he had 25 points in those three games, which still is a lot of points for T.J. Hall. Trying to get a double stack and open Hamilton up.
Wes Cooper won't go for him. Atkins rebounding.
The last two possessions that Navy has had when they've gotten the ball inside, they've gotten pushed away from the basket, which also leaves it wide open for Missouri to get a defensive rebound.
Melvin Booker now 12 points, hits another three-pointer. 48-39, Booker's come alive in the second half for Missouri. 8 minutes remaining. The number 16 seeds from the Naval Academy up against it now. Hopper inside, has to come back to Walker. Hamilton, he's a three-point shooter, but he's well short. Rebound by Cooper on the air ball. Push inside.
Missouri, personal foul. Number zero, Javon Kruda.
Kruda picks up the foul.
His first personal foul.
7:42 remaining, 48-39 Missouri.
The Women's Final Four, coming soon on CBS.
We designed a new car. We created a new class. We developed new engineering. We created a new standard of performance. We redefined value. Introducing the Mercedes-Benz C-Class. It wasn't designed to compete with other cars. It was designed to replace them. The new C-Class, starting at under $30,000.
Gentlemen, our attempts to stop the Energizer Bunny have failed. We've got to get his battery. And to do it, we need somebody big.
Big?
Big. end of the road, Mr. Energizer Bunny.
So you've done big bet.
Tally, hold it.
So you've done the South Pole.
Polarized it.
So you've done the Sphinx.
Sphinxed it.
But have you done the Dew?
So you've never done nothing.
Till you do the full tilt taste of Diet Dew.
Drank it.
Drank it.
Found it. Do it.
Every day, we all find a way.
A promise made.
Only the best garages display the NAPA Auto Care sign. You know they'll fix it right, using NAPA parts. No wonder Americans trust NAPA Auto Care Centers to keep their vehicles running.
We keep America running.
We keep America running.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Tim Ryan and Ann Myers here in Ogden, Utah. One game to follow. Cincinnati and the University of Wisconsin right now. The top seed, Missouri, leading Navy 48-39. 7:42 remaining. And the number 16 seeded Navy midshipman, a 17-12 mark coming into the game after a 5-10 start. And they will need a lot of luck, fortitude, and scoring ability here. Jerry West. Here in the audience watching today.
A lot of NBA scouts out there. Dick Mata's out there. Billy Knight's out there. I mean, you just go on and on. A lot of NBA people are here.
Hamilton, three.
4 of 8 for Hamilton from three-point range.
Cuts it to 6. 14 points on the game for Hamilton. Thames inside for Crudup, broken up by Hall. Missouri ball.
Well, just when you think Missouri has some breathing room, all of a sudden Navy just comes up with a big bucket.
Atkins, Crudup, Booker, Sutherland, and Thames, the lineup for Missouri. This is Thames. And the freshman, good move inside, hit the back iron. Crudup battling for the rebound, and he is fouled.
Hopper's going to get called for the foul, his third personal, but he's upset because he felt Crudup came over his back. Crudup, very strong.
His third personal foul. That's the third team foul.
Atkins goes out for Missouri.
Number 22, Lamont Frazier.
And Lamont Frazier returns for Navy.
At the free throw line.
They have Hamilton,
Crudup.
Walker, Hall, Cooper, and Coffer. Crudup hits the first.
Crudup has 11 double-doubles this season so far.
Nice touch from the free throw line from the big man, 11 points. Hall pops it up. Sutherland, and he missed the layup. Booker on the follow is fouled by Cooper.
Well, Sutherland felt he was fouled, but it's a situation, too. He's got to look and see where his teammates are and dish it off. T.J. Hall, not a great ball handler, and he gets caught with the ball on his hip because Walker brings his man right into him. Booker's open, but here, Sutherland's got to dish it now. He's got two wide-open guys behind him, and he tries to get the foul. They don't call it. But Booker's going to go to the line.
Missouri, number 15, Marvin Booker, will be at the free throw line. Shooting two.
T.J. Hall being a little the worse for wear, getting a breather on the Navy bench. Remember, as Ann told you, he's been bothered by a strep throat infection. He's been playing hard throughout this game.
Your head is probably just pounding.
Booker makes it 52-42, a 10-point Missouri lead now, 7:08 to go. The top-seeded Tigers, 14 points for Booker. 25-3 mark, 14-0 in the Big 8. Last year, they lost in the first round of the NCAA tournament to Temple, and they want to prove to the critics that they can advance here and be a contender as one of the top seeds in the tournament.
Missouri personal foul, number 22.
Third foul on Frazier.
His third, the personal foul. That is the fourth Missouri team foul.
Lamont Frazier, one of three seniors that starts for this Missouri team, but there's Crudup yelling again. You know he's coming down with the ball.
Copper missed two great chances for Navy. Walker comes up with the rebound. And it is finally knocked into the hoop by Ryan Torgrimson.
And Kelly Thames goes down.
We got cute.
Yeah. The guy.
And Thames holding that right knee.
Knee breaks.
Okay, okay. Relax. Catch it.
Kelly Thames, the outstanding freshman. Let's see it again. Ron Dubuque, the trainer out there to attend to him. Here's the play.
He went down before that. He's already grabbing the knee. So he was backing up on defense.
Substitution number 21, Marlo Finner.
Something went inside there when he made a certain move.
Kelly Thames, 15 points, 8 rebounds to this point. Norm Stewart is coming onto the field to check on his freshman.
He's in the middle. Comes up, he comes off that pick. You see him limping right off that pick. So he might have banged knees. There he is, he's already limping, but it can happen with the pick up high, the high post.
Well, Thames up on his feet at least and limping back to the Missouri bench. They lead 52-44. Mark Marlo Finner came in to replace him. Booker hits again. He's got 16. Melvin Booker, as Missouri leads 54-44 with 6:19 to go over the 16th-seeded Navy midshipman. And Booker goes to the line. He has had a very strong second half after Navy was battling them on even terms all the way to the 5-minute-to-go mark in the first half. And Norm Stewart said in his second unit, and from three down, they finished the half three up. When the starters came back out in the first part of the second half, they were on fire. And they have now a 9-point lead.
And their intensity level definitely picked up about 10 notches. Rebounding could have made a difference. And then Booker coming in and scoring some points. And also Thames was playing well for Missouri. Good hustle right there by Brad Coffer, the senior.
Coffer cuts it 55-47. To the line with a chance to make it a three-point play. Patriot Conference champions are battling this top seed of Missouri team with all they've got.
That is his second personal foul.
There's been a lot of delays in this game.
On Missouri, the 15th foul. For Navy, number 34, Brad Copper.
15 foul against Missouri. Copper missing on the free throw.
It's only the third free throw he has missed all year. He is 20 of 22 coming in.
Frazier. Off to Sutherland. Near steal. Crudup. He lost control going up to the basket. Stripped away by an Avian. Walker quickly the other way. Ryan Torgrimson off to Walker. Ten seconds on the shot clock. Walker inside for Cooper. Cooper going up is fouled before he got the shot off. Crudup, I believe, got the hand on him.
Missouri, personal foul. Number zero, Javon Crudup.
Jim Gray's got a report for us on the injured player Kelly Thames of Missouri. Jim?
All right, Tim. Thames is being attended to. In fact, he's just walking out right now. He ran into the knee brace of Brad Cooper and it cut him on some scar tissue on his right knee. It was bleeding. The scar tissue has now been bandaged up. He will be able to return. Back to you.
Thank you, Jim. Kelly Thames on the bench for the moment. 55-46 Missouri lead. Cooper on the line for Navy. Walker rebounding. Walker off the mark. Gets his own rebound.
Good hustle by Navy. That's what's going to keep them right there is that offensive rebounding.
Jim Hamilton, Brad Coffer, Hamilton for three off the front iron.
Boy, Hamilton really is going out, stretching it on those three-point shots.
Lamont Frazier. Ball still loose and out of bounds off Navy.
Substitutions for Navy, number 12, T.J. Hall.
So the clock working against Navy, 4:39 remaining to play. Walker goes out. D.J. Hall comes back in. Navy's lineup, Cooper Hall, Ryan Torgrimson, Hamilton, and Coffer. Now they want to make another change. And the brothers exchange places. Randy Torgrimson, the freshman, comes in to replace his older brother, Ryan.
Well, defensively, Navy's got to keep Missouri out of that paint area. And offensively, they've got to get not quick shots, but they've got to work their offense a little quicker where they're going to get the ball inside and try and create some fouls.
Crudup. Foul by Coffer. Looked like Crudup might have backed into him. Coffer didn't like the call, but that's four on Coffer.
Coffer and Crudup are really banging inside, and Crudup, as a matter of fact, came up high to get the ball, and then he did back into it. There was plenty of space in between, but Coffer, defensively, we can see on the replay, there's space right in between. He backs into him. Not much contact from the angle we see right there, but Coffer's still going to pick up his fourth personal.
Thames is back in the lineup with a knee wrap on. Thames for Missouri.
For Navy, they've got a player in T.J. Hall that they can score for them, but Navy's got to really work hard to get him open.
57-46, 11-point margin for Missouri, 4:23 to go. This is Hall. Hall for three. Yes.
3-point field goal.
T.J. Hall.
Wow.
His leading scorer's got 15. 57-49. Navy will not go away.
Talk about working to get open.
His second personal foul.
Just kind of squared up on Thames and knocked it down. Must have been contact on the arm.
Chance to make it a 4-point play for Hall. Can't do it. Thames has the rebound from Missouri. Three-pointer, Sutherland. So Missouri replies. 60-49.
Sutherland only shooting 17% coming into this game. 4 of 24. Knocks one down.
Contact inside and a foul called.
Navy personal.
They're
going to
call it on Coffer.
Hamilton.
No, Hamilton, but they're going to call the offensive foul on Jim Hamilton setting the pick.
His second personal foul. That's the seventh team foul.
Seventh team foul against Navy. Hamilton pleading his case. No avail.
At the free throw line, number 5, Jason Sutherland.
Sutherland with 5 points at the line. Hamilton rebounds. Oh, Hoffer rebounds. Back to Hall. Hall again. Can't get that one. And Missouri comes up with it. Sutherland by himself. Perfect feed from Booker. 62-49. Navy back quickly. Hamilton in and out. And Thames steps in nicely in front of Copper to grab the rebound.
Tigers have really done a good job in the second half, Tim, as far as the boards are concerned. Navy just really trying to catch up on the three-point shots now, and nothing going down for them. But Missouri really played tough defense on Navy.
64-49, 15 points for Crudup. Yvonne Crudup, number zero. Missouri Tigers, 14-0 over the regular season in the Big Eight. 15th appearance in the NCAAs and earning themselves one of the top seeds.
Navy personal foul, number 34, Brad Copper.
Copper picks up his fifth.
This is his fifth personal foul.
Personal foul, so it is all over for Copper, the senior from Kellogg, Idaho.
See in the half, second half. The inside game for Missouri, 24 points. They started penetrating off the dribble. They're big guys giving some offensive rebounds. Navy just really didn't have the height and the muscle to stay with Missouri in this second half. First half, Navy very impressive as far as controlling the tempo of the game.
Copper goes out, 4 points to his credit. A lot of hustle inside, good work on the boards for the senior. Sylvester Joseph, a freshman from DeRidder, Louisiana, has come in to replace him, a 6'3 forward. Thames at the line for Missouri. Brad Copper, the only senior on this Navy team, and you can see that it's been a grind out there for him, and perhaps his last game, it would appear to be that way, 65-49, with only 2:35 remaining.
He really had a tough matchup, too, against 6'9", Javon Crudup, playing in the middle, but he did a good job.
66-49, the top-seeded Tigers on top.
Well, it's that time of year again. So many games to watch. Hey, wait a minute. You might actually learn something. No, really. Did you know you can buy an Achieva Special Edition from Oldsmobile with anti-lock brakes, airbag, air, automatic, and more for just $13,995? So, did you learn anything? It's your money.
You got the winning color!
Make your engine last longer. Change your oil every 3,000 miles and use the newest Pennzoil. Now with a revolutionary Pennstar molecule, Pennzoil works like liquid ball bearings. Clings in, on, around, and between moving parts to reduce heat, friction, and wear like no other motor oil.
My car's got 295,000 miles on it.
It has 161,000 miles.
314,000.
173,000.
Pennzoil has always stood by me. It's never failed me.
You got the winning color!
To play this game, you gotta have the love, but most importantly...
Hey, man, you got the ball?
No, I ain't got the ball. You got... Say what?
You gotta have the ball. The all-new street ball. It's a Rawlings. It's only $4.99 and only at Pizza Hut.
Hey, Chubbs, win a game?
We're ball players and we're okay. We're not fat and lazy like the bonus say. In spring, we train real hard.
Yeah.
So we look good on our baseball cards. They're ball players, or so they say. They'd rather be doing ads for Ben Gay.
If they ain't in shape, they don't care. Just ink the deal to Hawk Underwear.
We're ball players and we're okay. Get in shape by opening day. Tanks to knees, we'll be ready to play. Oh, we'll ship your butts to Double A. Yeah.
What tire do you trust in the wet? A tire that removes over 2 gallons of water per second from under the tread. The all-season MX4. Another engineering splash from Michelin.
Tonight, laugh along with Sally Field, Carly Simon, and Robert Duvall.
Spouses who overspend on the next Dave.
I already put him in. I have to... We are back at Ogden, Utah, where Missouri leads 66-49, the top seed in the West, with 2:34 to go. I want to remind you, we'll be going to some games that are just getting underway. James Madison in Florida, Alabama against Providence. So the conclusion of this game, We'll be giving you a look at those. Later here, the final game of the day features Cincinnati and the University of Wisconsin. Grudup picks up his third personal foul, sending Cooper to the line. Grudup with 15 points and 10 rebounds. And Thames for Missouri, 17 points and 11 rebounds. They have really taken the boards away from Navy, particularly in the second half.
Wes Cooper, 6'5", junior, only 49.5% from the free throw line, hits that one, but average almost 10 points a game coming into this game, and hits his fifth point. Did a good job on the boards, though, for Navy.
Eight rebounds for Cooper. And there's another one for Prudhomme. 16-point lead for the Tigers. Second foul on Hall, stealing the ball from Sutherland. T.J. Hall, 6'3", junior from Fort Jefferson, New York, the leading Navy scorer. And what an effort he's put in here today, strep throat and all.
This is his first year on the varsity. Played 2 years for the junior varsity, T.J. Hall.
Brian Walker on the bench for Navy, and the exciting young freshman, unable to generate much in this ball game, the 5'8". Guard from Marion, Indiana. But how he contributed to Navy even getting here. 12 victories in his 15 starts, helping them to make that great comeback after a 5-10 win-loss record at the beginning of the season through their first 15 games. 68-50, 2:10 to go. Michigan leading only by 2 points over Pepperdine. Some time left in overtime. Bring you the conclusion of that, at least the score of that, I should say, to keep you up to date on Michigan's travails against Pepperdine.
Pepperdine, a big player with Dana Jones. 6'5 forward, does a great job for the Waves.
Shooting 1-1.
Sylvester Joseph at the line for Navy.
Played on the junior varsity team all season long, moved up to the varsity.
Sutherland. Grudup keeps it alive for Missouri. Grudup double teamed in the corner.
Navy personal foul.
And the foul is picked up by Randy Torgerson. Prudhomme at the line with 15 points in his pocket for Missouri.
You know, you figure, why do they foul down 18 points? But it's good concentration, I think, right now for Missouri. The sense of feeling that it's a...
All right, we're going to take a look at the finish of overtime. Michigan leading by two. Pepperdine with possession. Sean McDonough and Derek Dickey with the call in Wichita.
Michigan up by two, still trying to go to their strength, get the ball down low. Jalen Rose goes up for the shot, and a big block by Dana Jones coming from the weak side, and the Waves are being scrappy, getting after the ball. They're coming up with the loose ball possessions. Now they have a chance to tie.
Or win it, if they so choose. The shot clock is off. No timeouts left for Pepperdine. Lopez for three in the lead. Off the mark. Rebounded by King. He's fouled with 12 seconds left. Clark James called for the foul. They went for the lead and early with 12 seconds left.
I think the Wave wanted to get a shot open. They weren't as concerned about the clock as they were about getting an open shot for Damon Lopez, who we know can make that shot. He happens to miss it. The foul comes in from the backside by Clark James, sending the 66% free throw shooter, Jimmy King, to the line.
And it's 1-1 because it's only the ninth foul against Pepperdine. Michigan by two, 12 seconds left. King is 66% free throw shooter. 2 for 2 tonight. Made the first. I like the Pepperdine strategy, Derek, in that
you're a huge underdog. You don't want to keep going to another overtime against Michigan. When you have them on the ropes, you got to go for the kill while you can.
I agree with that. You don't want to continue to play with a team that is capable of getting back to the national championship again. Get a chance. If you get an open shot, take it and try to put it in.
That second free throw is huge. Now a two-possession game. Timeout, Michigan. 12 seconds left in overtime.
Here comes a new taste from the inventor of light beer. It's called Light Ice from Miller. It's 100% ice brewed for a taste that's more of what you want. Definitely light for less of what you don't.
What kind of beer is that?
It's new Light Ice from Miller.
In some ways, picking the winner of this championship is like buying a new car. So many to choose from. But how do you know for sure? Well, we were thinking more like Consumer's Digest magazine, who this year made the Oldsmobile 88 the only full-size sedan to be named a Consumer's Digest Best Buy 4 years in a row. Well, when you're hot, you're hot. It's your money.
For the first time, there's a saw that combines a 12-amp motor, dust collection, and an auto brake. So there's no limit to what you can build. Introducing the Quantum Circular Saw. New from Black & Decker.
Genuine jockey.
Real quality. Real fit. No wonder guys feel comfortable with jockey.
Genuine jockey.
This is the award-winning Goodyear Aqua Tread with its deep groove aqua channel. And this is the new Eagle Aqua Tread for performance sedans. A wider performance tire with two aqua channels to sweep water away. Now you get the wet traction of a Goodyear Aqua Tread and the performance of a Goodyear Eagle. One good turn deserves another. The new Eagle Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear. We say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
If Michigan hangs on to win this, they will have won it at the line. All eight of their points in overtime from the free throw line, where they're 8 for 8. Pepperdine needs a quick score of any kind. Parker was fouled. And it was Juwan Howard who hit the deck, and he's fouled out. With 28 points and 9 rebounds, Juwan Howard, 12 out of 17 from the floor, but he's the second Wolverine who have fouled out.
Tom Arisbury had a play designed to try to get the ball inbounds and try to draw a foul. You're going to see Dugan Fife running into a screen, but taking the ball to the basket is Brian Parker and drawing the fifth foul on Juwan Howard. And get a possession, get a score, as you talked about, at least come away with some points.
That was a well-designed play. They let the ball roll on the inbound to prevent the clock from starting. Then you saw the pick near half court to free a lane down the sideline for Brian Parker. Depending what happens here on the free throws, Pepperdine's going to need a quick steal or a quick foul with 8.3 seconds left.
It's important to make these free throws. You get the free throws, at least get under one possession. It gives you an opportunity to now go for that, make that gamble.
Two shots for Parker. Big free throw. The Waves within three with 8.3 seconds left in overtime. 10 points off the bench for Brian Parker. Made the second. Michigan with a two-point lead. Jason Bossert has come in for the first time of the game. Rose, and they get the quick foul. James fouled Rose with 7.1 remaining.
Dylan Rose normally is a pretty good free throw shooter, 74%, so he's going to have to make at least one of these free throws. And the worst that could happen is a tie. If he makes both, with 7 seconds on the clock, I think it's just about elementary.
Eight for eight in overtime and 17 out of 20 for the game for Michigan. The Wolverines during the regular season only a 67% free throw shooting team. 85% tonight, and that has been the difference. They've needed every one of those free throws they've made. No Michigan players in the lane. This is a two-shot opportunity for Jalen Rose. 6 out of 8 from the line tonight. 74% for the year. If he makes this one, it's just about over. Deborah Nyman needs two possessions again in the final 7.1 seconds. All right, a foul on a three-point shot. Four-point lead for Michigan. The Wolverines would be wise to back away from Lopez. He threw it cross-court. Launch at the buzzer, short, and Michigan survives a major scare from Pepperdine. Texas takes on Western Kentucky in about a half an hour. The Chevrolet players of the game, Damon Lopez of Pepperdine at 21 points on 7 three-pointers. Jawan Howard of Michigan at 28 points and 9 rebounds. A check in the amount of $1,000 will be donated to each college's general scholarship fund to further assist qualified students in all chosen academic fields. Now let's join Jim Nance in New York. Jim.
Thank you, Sean, and I think you said it right. Michigan survives tonight, the first overtime game of the 94 tournament, 78-74 victory for the Wolverines. Missouri has just gone final. This was tied 33-all in the second half, and then Missouri outscored the Middies 43-20 down the stretch. James Madison in Florida tied at 11 with 9 minutes to go in the first half. Some will be going there momentarily to see that game, Alabama and Providence. And the Friars have led throughout this game. In fact, as much as 9 points. But right now it's trimmed to 3 with 7:49 to go in the first half. Now, here's the next round of games. Again, those of you expecting Alabama-Providence, we're going to be sending you there. Others are supposed to get James Madison, Florida. We'll be joining that game. For those of you expecting to see Wisconsin-Cincinnati or Western Kentucky-Texas, they're 1.5 hour from tip-off, and we're going to start you out with Alabama and Providence. And we'll continue here on CBS on the road to Charlotte in just a moment. Madness is underway, huh?